Probably you might have, of course everybody might have, come across the words like one by one, one after the other, a test cricket match series and TV serials, frequency of the buses moving from one destination to the other, etc. For all such words, there is a common word in mathematics that is called a sequence. Exactly, what is sequence? A sequence is a list of objects or events arranged in an array such that each object is obtained from the preceding object by a certain rule. More formally, it is just a function f from n to a, where n is the set of natural numbers. To verify this definition, we are considering some examples here, namely 1, 3, 7, 11, 15, so on so forth. This array of numbers is a sequence because this is a set of these numbers are arranged in an array, and also each object, each number is obtained from previous object by a certain rule. Rule is here the second object, namely 7 is obtained from 3 by adding 4, and 11 is obtained from 7 by adding 4, and 15 is obtained from 11 by adding 4, and hence this example very well fits into the definition. The second example, now can consider 5, 10, 20, 40, 80. This array of numbers is also sequence because each number is obtained from the previous number by multiplying 2. 10 is obtained from 5 by multiplying 2. 20 is obtained from 10 by multiplying 2. And 40 is obtained from 20 by multiplying 2. And 80 is obtained from 40 by multiplying 2, so on so forth. And one more example, now you can see 1 by 2, 2 by 3, 3 by 4, 4 by 5, so on so forth. This array of fractions is also a sequence because each fraction is obtained from the previous fraction by rule. What is that rule? Rule is by adding 1 to the numerator and 1 to the denominator also. 3 by 4 is obtained by 2 by 3 by adding 1 to the numerator and 1 to the denominator. Similarly, 4 by 5 is obtained from 3 by 4 by adding 1 to the numerator and 1 to the denominator. And hence, these array of fractions form a sequence. Now, you might have a doubt in your mind that is the sequence only confined to numbers only? It may not be true because the very definition itself suggests that it is a list of objects or events. Objects may be anything, maybe numbers, or maybe some kind of goods or some kind of figures, or particularly geometrical figures, are events like TV sorry, cricket match serials, etc., etc. And therefore, the sequence need not confine to numbers only. The, for example, fourth example I am giving you here, a sequence of polygons, a geometrical figure. Now here, this array of polygons form a sequence because here each polygon is obtained from the previous polygon by a certain rule. Rule now I am quoting here. What is that? You consider, for example, a rectangle polygon with the four sides and remove one side, whatever may be the side, maybe horizontal line or left line or right line, then take a new point and along with this broken polygon, let us say broken polygon, and this is so, add a new point and join it to the end point of the polygon, broken polygon, so you will get a pentagon. Similarly, you can get a polygon with six sides from the pentagon by removing one line, and similar fashion you will get a broken polygon and add a new point and join it to the end vertices of that broken polygon, so you will get a polygon with six sides. And one more example I am going to give you here. Six test matches. Matches. A cricket match, of course. Played on an alternative day, begin with Monday. Now you can see here the first test match played on Monday, second match or second test played on Wednesday, and the third test played on Friday, alternative day, and fourth one played on Sunday, and the fifth one played on Tuesday, sixth one played on Thursday. So the events, array of events, also form a sequence. Now I am giving some examples here. Which of the following arrays form the sequences? Now I am giving some examples here for your exercise. Now you can see here 1, 2, 5, 8, 9, 15, 28, 29, 46, 85. This array of numbers, whether it is a sequence or not. Second example, here I am giving you 2 by 4, 6 by 8, 11 by 12, 15 by 20, so on and so forth. And third one, I am going to give you here a kind of a figures, arrows, array of arrows I am giving you here. One after the other. And with these three examples, I would like to ask you to find out which of the following sequences, array of objects or numbers, form a sequence. In the next example, next video, I am going to consider a notation, how to denote the sequences in a symbolic manner, how to denote the terms in the sequences in a symbolic manner, and also we are going to find out the nth term in a sequence or a general term of a sequence. Let us see in the next video.